And if you look at what's happening, I think it's pretty easy to figure out what's going on. I mean, suppose you're a literary scholar at some elite university, or anthropologist or whatever. I mean, if you do your work seriously, that's fine, you know. But it's not very. I mean, you don't get any big prizes for it. On the other hand, you take a look over in the rest of the university, and you got these guys in the physics department and the math department, and they have all kind of complicated theories, which of course we can't understand, but they seem to understand them, and they have principles, and they deduce complicated things from the principles, and they do experiments, and they find either they work or they don't work, and so, and that's really impressive stuff. So I want to be like that too. So I want to have a theory in literary, in the humanities, literary criticism, anthropology, and so on. There's a field called theory. We're just like the physicists. They talk incomprehensibly. We can talk incomprehensibly. They have big words. We'll have big words. They draw, far-reaching conclusions. We'll draw far-reaching conclusions. We're just as prestigious as they are. Now, if they say, well, look, we're doing real science and you guys aren't, that's white, male, sexist, bourgeois, whatever the answer is. How are we any different from them?
Disgusting, razzle dazzle them, and they'll never catch wise. Give them the old razzle dazzle, razzle dazzle them. Give them a show that's so splendiferous, row after row, row vociferous. Give them the old. Razzle dazzle them, and they'll beg you for more. Give them the old double whammy, days and dizzy young. Back since the day. Show on the first
no talents. Razzle dazzle them.